Welcome back, students. We were discussing the topic diversity in living things. So now let's discuss about the classification of invertebrates. Invertebrates are the animals without backbone, and there are basically 8 groups of invertebrates. First is mollusks, flatworms, annelids, roundworms, sponges, gynoderms, cnidarians, and the orthopods. So basically these 8 groups are invertebrates include, first one is mollusk. The mollusk have crawl, they can crawl on a single fleshy pad and they have a shell. So basically snails and all these are the animals which fall in the category of mollusk, and they have shell on their body. Next comes the flatworm. Flatworms have they have flat leg bodies. As you can see, there is a flat shaped body these flatworms are having. Next comes the annelids. Annelids have roundworm like bodies, and their bodies have are divided into segments in the annelids. Next comes the roundworms. They have long thin roundworm like bodies. As you can see, there is rounded bodies and they have body have no segments. These are basically the roundworms. Next comes the sponges. Sponges have the bodies which are made up of loosely bound, loosely joined cells. So these are the sponges. Next comes the echinoderms. Echinoderms have the bodies which are divided into 5 parts and they have spiny outer covering. The example of this can be echinoderm, basically the starfish. Starfish is an example of echinoderms. So students, in this session we have seen first the mollusk which crawl on a single fleshy pad. Basically the snails are included in the mollusk. Next comes the flatworms which have flat bodies. So the worms which have flat bodies are considered as flatworms. Next comes the annelids. They are the roundworm like shape, and their body, basically the annelids have segments. Next comes the roundworms. Roundworms have rounded body, roundworm like bodies, and the bodies have don't have segments. Next comes the sponges. Their bodies are made up of loosely joined cells. Next one is the echinoderms. They have the bodies divided into 5 parts, and basically starfish is the example which have spiny outer covering. So students, in this session we have seen the classification of invertebrates. For the session we will have a more detailed look regarding the diversity of living things.